Hello, in today's video we're going to be looking at the iFi Uno, which is sort of a mix between the Go Link that we looked in the last video and something bigger such as the Zen 2, which we looked at a few months ago. So it's sort of a middle ground. It's very lightweight. I wouldn't say it's mobile as in you'd have it in your pocket all the time, because it's not that small, but it is very lightweight and you could take it around and just plug it in on your desk wherever you go. It definitely would fit in your bag, and it's, as I say, very, very lightweight. The Uno supports all of the things you normally get out of an iFi DAC, which is PCM up to 384 kHz. It supports DSD and has a MQA renderer on board. So like all the rest of them, this supports virtually everything out of the box. The main things to boast about the iFi Uno is the analog style volume controller on the front of the device, and it's got power match, which helps when you're using like open back headphones and that, which is quite useful, and equalizer. So it's got four equalizer settings, which one is off, one is for game streaming. I'll show you a bit more later on in the video how that affects the audio. You've got streaming, which is for movies and for listening to streams. And then you've just got an audio setting. I'll go through what effects these have on your audio with some testing later on in the video. But let's go straight on into the unboxing and see what you get in the box. And then we'll move on to the testing a bit later on. So inside the box, you have the Uno itself. A sticker, a little quick start guide, and the usual sort of documentation. Worth mentioning here, it's worth downloading the latest drivers from the iFi website. And USB-C cable to USB-A. Looking at the Uno in a bit more detail itself. On the front you've got the EQ, which changes the mode. Power match, which is the thing for the headphones, and obviously the volume dial. And these light up depending on the mode that you're in. On the back, you've got your RCA and your USB-C input. Yeah, just a tactile click to turn it on, and then your volume. So in the making of this video, I realised that I don't really have a definitive way of testing or proving the output of an audio DAC, and particularly the different settings that they're using with the equalizer. So I set about finding a way to do that. So I've been testing with an oscilloscope, and I've got a few charts to throw up on the screen, and I've also got a couple of defaults to show you to sort of compare to, and which also shows you the quality of the sound that's coming out. Just a note, all these charts will be available on my website, and I'm going to start testing everything with these same methods. So any videos coming out in the future will have the same sort of charts, and then you can go on the website and compare them against things that you want to see, and hopefully make an informed choice on things in the future. But they'll all be on the website, and I'll link it to that in the description below. So I'm not going to go into too much detail about the recording method used. If you want to find out about that, I'll have information on the website about the methods used. But first of all, I'm going to show you a generic PC DAC output. This is not the iFi itself. And as you can see, as I overlay the area in red, you can see that the actual signal itself is quite wide. I know you've got nothing to compare it to yet, but you'll see in a second. In the presence and the sub bass at the two ends of the spectrum, you've got quite a wide signal. And this sort of shows that the signal is quite messy. And not very accurate to what's being represented in the sound. And now I'm going to show you the iFi Uno in its default state without an equalizer switched on. And as you can see, the signal is much finer, which shows that you're getting a much more accurate sound output. And everything's a lot tighter. In comparison, it's really high up into the presence range before you start to get that widening of the wave. And down in the sub basses, it's a very, very accurate all the way down to the lowest frequencies. See, if I put them side by side, you can see there's a massive difference in the waveforms and just how tight and accurate they are. Next, I'm going to show you with the audio equalizer enabled. And I'll just put the original default over the top, which is the higher line in orange. And as you can see, it just has a slight effect by increasing the bass right down there in the sub bass and slightly into the bass range. So there is a very slight difference between the default and the audio setting. And next we have the stream setting, and you can already see there's some dips, but I'll overlay the default over the top again. It's similar to the audio setting down in the bass range, and you can see you've got a dip here in the sort of mid-high section, and that's to increase the enunciation of voices when you're listening to movies and things like that over sort of ambiance and background noise. And finally, we have the game EQ. Similarly, you can see there's a few differences here. Just as I overlay, there's a few changes to the bass, and again, there's a peak down in the presence. Most importantly, we have a spike right in between the mid-low and the bass section. And this little spike is right in the range of where you'd hear footsteps. So that's obviously for the reason that you'd be able to hear footsteps in game, hopefully be able to hear where people are coming from. And the other spikes in the bass and the presence are to hopefully help you hear firing, so you can hopefully listen to what direction is coming from. So overall in testing, a really tight, nice signal, and the equalizers do what they say on the tin. They are producing a different sound wave depending on the type of media you're listening to. Okay, so we've looked at all the testing data, but what do I think of the iFi Uno? I think it's a really good sort of middle point between, as I said earlier, the Go Link, which is ready for you on the go, and the Zen, which is quite an expensive product. This is a really good, you get a lot for your money here, and really a good entry point for hi-fi DACs. In all honesty, I don't do a lot of FPS gaming, but I can see where that sort of setting in the middle there would be quite useful if you were sort of doing esports and that sort of thing. But for me, I basically leave it on the audio setting. That just gives it that little tweak of a nicer sound, I found. I didn't really find many times, other than when I was trying to test the difference, where I found that I needed to switch between the settings because I thought that I'd get a better sound from one rather than the other. And I can say, if you're listening to audio, stick it on the audio or the off setting, because if you stick it in any other mode, the gaming or the streaming sound, they sound terrible. But they are good for exactly what they're designed for, which is boosting those different points in the sound spectrum for when you need them. I've talked about the power match before. That seems to work really well with my open back headphones. It's just a really useful feature that I've found on all of the devices that support it so far. The Go Link didn't, so that was quite a big difference. And if you remember in that video, I said how the basses were a bit flat on the Go Link in comparison to this, which has got that extra power that you're looking for definitely for open back headphones. The amount of functionality, considering the size of this, is quite impressive. You've got the USB-C input, but you've also got the RCA out on the back, which I wasn't expecting, to be honest. I thought this would just be a headphone DAC for the size and the price of it, but no, it does support that as well, which is quite impressive. So overall, I really like the Uno. You're really getting a lot for the price you're paying here, and I'd recommend it on that factor alone. This is a great starting point for anyone getting into decent audio DACs, and it's a really good small device you just chuck on your desk and is going to function to a really high level for just a really cheap price. But that's all I've really got to say about that. So if you've got any questions, I'd love to answer them in the comment section below. If not, find us on Twitter or reach out to us on Discord, and there'll also be a blog post coming along with this video with some of the more detailed side of the drawings and graphs that I've displayed on the screen for you to look over and potentially compare to other things in the future. So that's it, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks a lot.